then we'll see the rest of the topic later on. But now let us switch towards industrial revolution. Why industrial revolution? Because 18th century, it's also the beginning of industrial revolution. So let us try to understand this. So industrial revolution, whenever somebody uses this word, what is the meaning of this? Adoption of a system of producing commodities on a large scale in huge factories. In fact, machine-based production, factory-based production, large-scale production, it is linked with industrial revolution. Industries are something which were not that much famous in the early 18th century. But slowly, England was able to become the harbinger. It could become the birthplace of industrial revolution, and we'll try to understand it. If you see the industrial revolution, it has many phases. I hope all of you know that right now we are going through the which phase? Fourth phase of industrial revolution. And in fact, we are already talking about the fifth phase. The moment AI or this is going to become very superior, that is going to be considered as the fifth phase of industrial revolution. Okay, generative AI jab us level pe aa jayega, normally it is going to be considered as fifth phase. Anyway, so for the first phase, it was mostly led by which industry? Cotton industry. Ab dhyan rakhna, the first phase of industrial revolution, it was led by which industry? Cotton. Maximum innovation happened in the cotton, and later on, okay, later on it was led by iron. The second industrial revolution, it was led by iron. Iron became very popular, and various kinds of processes were utilized. And the moment we see the production of iron on large scale, it helped in the rise of infrastructure in the countries. So cotton was very important from the point of view of the first industrial revolution, and in the later one we see the rise of other specific features. What are the major features of an industrial revolution? Number one, it's going to be science-based revolution. Why science-based? Because scientific principles were applied to improve the industrial processes. Without innovation, without technology, can we have industrial revolution? No, it can never happen. In fact, you have to remember it all the time. UPSC can ask this question, that why did industrial revolution started in England? There were so many factors responsible for that, but the most important factor, the most catalytic factor, it is the science. Okay, jaisa fourth industrial revolution hai, usko India lead kar raha hai, USA lead kar raha hai? USA lead kar raha hai. Open AI kahan pe? India mein thodi na hai, hai na? When he came to India, we asked ki bhai hum also, we can also lead AI. He said don't try. Sam Altman, he said don't try, we are going to be ahead of you. What's the reason for that? Because they are far ahead of us in the innovation. We are far ahead in jugaad. Jugaad mein hum log sabse aage hain to make things work somehow. But when it comes to pure innovation, USA is far ahead of us. That's why every industrial revolution requires science. Use of new materials. Okay, science, steel, they become dominant material for machine as well as infrastructure. Why? Because if you want to make machine, machine should be durable in nature. And when they will be durable? When they have very hard level of raw material. And what is that going to be? Iron and steel. New energy sources. Previously, majority of the production, it used to happen in the homes. But now, coal, steam, electricity, they replace the traditional fuels like water and or mechanization of very high level. Maximum number of machines were created. Now, the people were required to operate them, not work individually. Factory system. Previously, home-based production was there. Now, that was shifted towards factory. Transportation and communication. This also improved with the period of time. And finally, the most important thing, that is mass production. So, if you can remember these points, it can help you in your answer writing. Abhi hum kuch answers likhenge day after tomorrow. So, please remember that industrial revolution is a very important topic, and in fact, UPSC asks question every year. Now, let us try to understand what were the causes of industrial revolution in England. Why England became the major face of industries in 18th century? There were so many factors which were linked to this. Like number one, economic and trade factors. If we look at them, yesterday we had discussed the word commercial revolution. So the first important keyword is commercial revolution. People had already gained a lot because of commercial revolution. They were having the wealth, and when they were having the wealth, they were ready to invest. So that's why paisa haath mein nahi hoga to investment kaise karoge. Like when somebody says what are the four factors of any production, to mein kya kya hoga? Land, labor, then we have capital. Without capital, we cannot have industries, we cannot run any major offices. That's why commercial revolution has already happened in England. Second, colonial supremacy. They were able to capture large parts in the world, and that's why from there also they were getting the wealth, which could again be utilized for the creation of industry. Then expanding domestic market. The population had increased drastically. like right now when somebody asks about ki India ki jo GDP growth rate ho jyada kyun hogi, so we always say that we have very high level of youth population, we have demography by our side, jo ki abhi 2040-2045 tak hum sab youth log aate hi rahenge, we'll have the highest labor force in the world in fact. So that is nothing but that is the expansion of domestic market. When the population increases, it increases your potential for the growth. However, there should be equivalent opportunities. Agar jobs nahi honge to demographic dividend ki jagah demographic kya jata hai, disaster ban jata hai, because jobs nahi honge to crime rate increase hoga, wealth from colonies, political and social factors. One of the biggest reason why industrial revolution started in England not in France is their political stability. France was always in the fighting mode. Britain, it is an island. Okay, it was never invaded before the world wars. World wars mein pehli baar usko invade kiya gaya hai, usse pehle wo kabhi invade hi nahi hua. So that's why it is having political stability and people are of conservative mindset. They are not like French ki har teesre din Paris ki street pe aake chalo revolution karte hain. That is in the blood. Now, nobody can do anything about it. 1789, 1830, 1848, large number of revolutions line by line, Napoleon always fighting in the continental Europe. So that's why political stability and liberal environment fostered industrial development. Then you also require raw material. If raw material is missing, to ye sab hone ke baad bhi kuch nahi hone wala. Next is abundant coal and iron. So they were very close by. In fact, many of you would know the concept of their weight losing industry. Bahut sara inke andar se unnecessary cheeze nikalti hain. To agar jitna pass mein hota hai, transportation ka cost kam ho jata hai. That's why that was also a natural factor in the case of England. Agriculture advances also. In England, they had went through various methods to improve the output of agriculture. In fact, there was one enclosure movement through which they did consolidation of land holding. So, India mein aaj ke time mein sabse bada problem kya hai in agriculture? We have 86% of the farmers. They are small and marginal. Uska issue kya ho jata hai uski wajah se? The average output which can come from a field, wo kuch jyada nahi hota hai. It is hardly for the basic survival. They are not able to sell. They are not able to make their living. Those kinds of problems were already changed by the Britain in the 17th and 18th century. So agriculture was already going towards consolidation. So labor force was ready. Jin logon ne agriculture chhod diya tha, wo ab kya kar sakte hain? They can become part of the manufacturing processes. So that's why a labor force was required and came out of agriculture. India mein bhi jab bhi aapko ek suggestion dena ho in economy, if you want to improve the GDP of India, one thing is shift the labor form from agriculture to नॉन एग्रीकल्चर, और वही एग्जैक्टली इन लोगों ने किया था. वेल एस्टैब्लिश्ड पोर्ट्स, इफ यू आर एन आइलैंड तो पोर्ट्स का तो इशू ही नहीं है, जिस डायरेक्शन में जाओगे पोर्ट मिलने वाला आपको, है ना, किसी भी डायरेक्शन में चले जाओ. देन ज्योग्राफिकल लोकेशन, इट इज ऑल्सो वेरी प्रोमिनेंट, विच इज समथिंग ऑफ स्ट्रेटेजिक बिटवीन द ईस्ट एंड द वेस्ट. एंड फाइनली फेवरेबल क्लाइमेट, ब्रिटेन इज कंसिडर्ड एज हैविंग वन ऑफ द बेस्ट क्लाइमेट इन द वर्ल्ड, एंड इनफैक्ट फॉर द इवन फॉर द ह्यूमन ग्रोथ, ओके, और द ग्रोथ ऑफ द माइंड. अब इंडिया में क्या है, इतना हीट वेव चल रही है, आधे लोग बेचारा बाहर निकल के दिमाग काम नहीं कर रहा है, हीट स्ट्रोक्स आ रहे हैं. दैट्स व्हाई वी नीड फेवरेबल क्लाइमेट आल्सो. सो द टेम्परेट क्लाइमेट वाज आइडियल फॉर द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ कॉटन क्लोथ. तो कुछ कुछ प्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस के लिए भी चाहिए, जैसे कॉटन जो है उसको थोड़ा सा कैसा वाला एयर चाहिए, कॉटन को कैसा चाहिए होता है, ड्राई नहीं चाहिए होता, थोड़ा सा वेट साइड में चाहिए होता है, ठीक है. तो हर किसी का अपना एक स्पेसिफिक रिक्वायरमेंट होता है. सो along with this, some very important inventions were also done by them. Because देखो, अगर science and tech में आगे नहीं हो तो industrial revolution कभी नहीं होगा. These people came out with so many new innovations in the cotton industry. Like one of the most famous invention, one of the first one, it was flying shuttle. It was established by John Kay. And इसने क्या किया? It doubled the weaver's output. कि एक इंसान जो एक बार ये बुन पाता हो वो double हो गया because of flying shuttle. Second came spinning jenny, invented by James Hargreaves. It would spin 8 times thread simultaneously. तो आपका जो output है वो एकदम से dramatically increase हो जाता है, जो 1x से 8x हो गया. Then comes water frame developed by Richard Arkwright. It would spin 128 threads at once. Then Crompton's mule, which has helped in the yarn production. And as a result of all these inventions, cotton industry boomed. You see the level of production. In 1700 it was how much? 500 ton. But by 1860, 5 lakh ton. This is industrial revolution. Okay, the industrial revolution started roughly around 1750. So, लगभग 100 साल के अंदर देखो उन्होंने कहाँ से कहाँ को production लेके चले गए. And that's why we call it industrial revolution. Revolution, the word itself means that fundamental changes are going to happen. And when fundamental changes happen, nobody can go back. Like today we have smartphone. Smartphone अब कभी नहीं जाने वाले हमारी जिंदगी से. It's a fundamental revolution. ना हर चीज के लिए हम dependent हो गए हैं. Previously they were also just for calling, but today entertainment, staying connected with people, social media, everything that we are consuming, it is coming through our phones, banking transaction, everything. So that's a fundamental change in our life. We cannot go back now. Possible ही नहीं है. Manchester came to be known as Cottonopolis because of the banner in which the cotton was produced. So that's why England became the harbinger of industrial revolution. Later on, for the iron industry, in 1709, Abraham Darby, he came out with a coke for the smelting process. Steam pump was developed. Then James Watt came out with the steam engine. उन्होंने वो develop किया. So iron also became very prominent industry by the early 19th century as a result of this. That's why innovations were very, very important. For transportation, steamboat was developed in 1802, locomotive by 1804, first passenger railway by 1830. India में कब आया था? 1853. Okay? And that जो first था उसका नाम भी उन्होंने क्या रखा था? The rocket. है ना, मजेदार नाम रखा था. So these are the major inventions which we see. Later on, transatlantic steamships, iron ships, all those things were developed by the British. Then, for the road and communication, John Loudon McAdam, he invented an effective and economical road construction method. जब भी हम industrial revolution की बात करते हैं, we need forward and backward linkages. And those forward and backward linkages are going to be linked only on the basis of roads. Roads ही नहीं बनेंगे या railway setup नहीं बनेगा तो कैसे आपका easily import export होगा जो भी चीज आपने करना है, raw material time पे कैसे आएगा. So that's why it was required. Telegraph, this was also created first in 1835. Undersea cables were laid down by 1851. So telegraph became very important for the communication purpose. And urbanization, see the growth of cities. In 1750 only London and Edinburgh had population over 50,000. But by 1851, so साल के अंदर 29 cities were having that much population. So industrial revolution and urbanization, they were going simultaneously. ये same चीज हर जगह नहीं हो पाई. जैसे कि फ्रांस में ऐसा नहीं हो पाया, इंडस्ट्रियल रेवल्यूशन स्टार्ट हुआ लेकिन अर्बनाइजेशन इतना नहीं हो पाया साथ में. बट इन इंग्लैंड इट वॉज कम्प्लीटली सिनोनिमस. ये भी बढ़ रहा है, वो भी बढ़ रहा है साथ में. सो वी सी राइज ऑफ मेनी इंडस्ट्रियल सेंटर्स. ओके, देन द सेकेंड स्टेज ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल रेवल्यूशन, ये फर्स्ट फेज था जो लगभग 1840 के आसपास तक चलता है. 1840-1850. The second phase starts from 1850 and goes up to 1880s. In this second phase, we have even more scientific innovations. We have more increase in the production levels. Industrial and commercial development, they also increased. And in fact, there was also an impact of Napoleonic War. Commerce for a time kind of dislodge hua, but again, it eventually picked up. The industrial revolution reached a very high level during the post-war period after 1815. Uska fir se increase ho gaya. Then many other achievements like Michael Faraday. Today all of us, our life are completely dependent upon electricity. So he was the one who invented the concept of electricity. Thomas Alva Edison, hai na, bina light ki padhai kaise karoge? So he was the one who came out with the light bulb. So utilities in the life and the mass production continued with the period of time. Then Germany's industrialization, that also started after 1830s. They created one custom union known as Zollverein in 1834, and this became very helpful in their unification also. Diesel engine was brought in by Rudolf Diesel. हम तो diesel ऐसे word use करते, कहाँ से आया diesel word? Rudolf Diesel, he invented the diesel engine, and that's why later on we see the rise of automobile industry. So automobile industry भी उसके साथ में चलने लग गई. Prominent German industries, iron and steel production, chemical industry, they are still the pioneer. आज भी इनकी सबसे फेमस इनकी कंपनीज हैं, लीडिंग कंपनीज जैसे बायर एंड होइस्ट आर स्टिल द लीडर्स. लेटर ऑन इफ यू कंपैरेटिवली सी, तो जर्मनी एमर्ज एज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट इंडस्ट्रियल कंट्री बाय द एंड ऑफ द 19th सेंचुरी. बाय 1899, बाय 1900 दे वर वन ऑफ द मोस्ट प्रोमिनेंट एंड दे इवन सरपास्ड ब्रिटेन. यूएसए बिकेम एन इंपॉर्टेंट इंडस्ट्रियलाइज्ड कंट्री ओनली आफ्टर देयर सिविल वॉर आफ्टर 1865. इनिशियली इट वॉज नॉट हैविंग दैट मच ऑफ technology, but after the American Civil War, they were also going to take lots of steps in their eventual kickstart. They also have some famous people like Samuel Slater. He was a person who migrated from England, learned how to go for the production of the textile and started the process in the USA. Then there was one Andrew Jackson, who is considered the father of industrial revolution there. Pre-Civil War innovation includes Samuel Morse telegraph and Elias Howe's sewing machine. Post-Civil War, large number of things were brought in, like transcontinental railroad, okay, then light bulb, and eventually telephone. Telephone, as all of us understand, by Graham Bell. Social and demographic changes also happened. Immigration increased on a very high level. That's why USA still remains the land of opportunities. Talent kept on coming from outside, and they were responsible for its growth and development. So large workforce ban gaye inke. However, as a result of this industrial revolution, which has begun in England and then spread to the rest of the part of the world, new challenges came on the scene for the humans. And the biggest challenge was how to distribute wealth. Because with the rise of industrial revolution, we see rise of capitalism. And with capitalism, worse things come into the picture. We have one bourgeois class, and the second, we have second proletariats. That's the problem which we see. Okay, so the owner of the new industries, they took away all the profits. However, the working class, it was suffering. There was no sufficient labor laws. The salaries were meager. Working conditions were very, completely problematic. So that's why it is a very famous quote that industrial revolution solved the problem of production, but not the problem of distribution of new wealth created. Production to bada di taki log consume kar sake, but jo usse paisa aa raha hai, profit aa raha hai, usko kaise distribute kare, that problem could not be solved. And as a result of this, we see emergence of two new classes in the world history. And what are those? Bourgeois and proletariat. And in fact, this is the reason which is responsible for the rise of socialism and later on communism. Okay. These topics are directly connected. These topics are directly connected. This was the first PPT that we discussed.
Hi, a very good evening to all of you. I'm Vikas Helawat. I'm a former civil servant. I was able to crack UPSC twice. In fact, in 2018, I was able to get highest marks in history optional, and they were around 324. So this year, I'm coming up with a series which I'm calling Self-Study History Optional. This series mein 100 se zyada video hone wale hai, which are going to cover the different nuances of ancient, medieval, modern, as well as world history. So those of you who are preparing for 2025, register kariye and try to get the maximum out of this specific initiative of ours. So at Prep Career IAS, we are producing results from last many years. 2023 में बहुत सारे टॉपर्स हमारे इंस्टीट्यूट से थे. 2022-21 हर साल बहुत अच्छे टॉपर्स यहाँ से निकले हैं. And they have been able to get very good marks in history optional. So those of you who are thinking कि यार स्टार्ट करके कितना कर पाएंगे कितना नहीं कर पाएंगे, we already have achievements with us. I was able to achieve, my students are achieving, and you can be the next. इन सेशंस में क्या होने वाला है? नंबर वन, विल बी फोकसिंग ऑन फाउंडेशन ऑफ बेसिक कंसेप्ट्स, स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम व्हाट इज हिस्ट्री, व्हाट इज हिस्टोरिकल पीरियड, व्हाट इज प्रोटो हिस्ट्री, व्हाट इज प्री हिस्ट्री, बेसिक लेवल. ओके, सेकंड, अलाइनमेंट विद यूपीएससी सिलेबस. जितना भी हिस्ट्री ऑप्शनल का सिलेबस है वो 51 पार्ट्स में डिवाइडेड है. सो वी आर गोइंग टू अलाइन ईच एंड एवरी कंसेप्ट विद द सिलेबस इटसेल्फ. नंबर थ्री, वी आर गोइंग टू फोकस ऑन आंसर राइटिंग. ऑल ऑफ यू नो कि जो मेन्स है वो ऑब्जेक्टिव नहीं होता है, वो सब्जेक्टिव लेवल पे होता है, और आप सब लोगों को आंसर राइटिंग सीखना शुरू करना पड़ेगा, है ना. वी डू नॉट हैव टू मच ऑफ टाइम, तो जस्ट स्टार्टिंग से ही आंसर राइटिंग शुरू करेंगे. एंड नंबर फोर, द ओवरऑल पैकेज इज वेरी होलिस्टिक इन नेचर. तो अगर आप इसको अच्छे से कर लेते हैं तो जो बेसिक लेवल फाउंडेशन हिस्ट्री ऑप्शनल की वो कंप्लीट हो जाएगी. You are going to get many important things along with this, okay? 100 plus session है, चारों part cover होंगे. Theme wise segregated diagram, flowchart, जितने भी important NCRTs हैं. देखो, अगर हम सारी NCRTs को combine कर दें, ancient, medieval, modern world of various boards of India, तो 25 से 26 NCRT निकल के आती हैं. उन सबको हमने coherent form में design किया है, so that you can learn the best from that. ओके, बिकॉज देखो हिस्ट्री में रिसर्चेस चलती रहती हैं. अभी तमिलनाडु की जो एनसीईआरटीज हैं, दे आर मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट इन कंपैरिजन टू द रीसेंट हिस्ट्री देन द प्रीवियस हिस्ट्री, जो कि आर एस शर्मा वगैरह, सतीश चंद्रा या फिर बिपिन चंद्रा ने लिखी है. दैट्स वाई वी आर कवरिंग ऑल द एनसीईआरटीज, एंड दैट्स वाई 100 प्लस सेशंस हो जा रहे हैं टोटल मिला के. देन 30 प्लस वैल्यू एडेड आपको डॉक्यूमेंट मिलने वाले हैं, डेडिकेटेड आंसर राइटिंग सेशन मिलेंगे, जूम सेशंस भी करेंगे बाद में, ताकि आप लोगों की जितने भी डाउट्स हों विद रिस्पेक्ट टू लर्निंग दे कुड बी सॉल्व. ओवरऑल जो है आपको क्लास की पीपीटीज मिलेंगी, कंसेप्ट लिस्ट मिलेगा, PYQs, जितने भी PYQs हैं उनको अच्छे से हमने डिज़ाइन कर दिया ताकि आप सब उनको अच्छे से पढ़ सकें, माइंड मैप मिलेंगे पूरे सिलेबस के, वर्कबुक और लर्निंग असाइनमेंट्स मिलेंगे एंड सेल्फ असेसमेंट टेस्ट, सो दैट वंस यू लर्न समथिंग तो साथ में उसको एटलीस्ट इवेल्युएट भी करना चाहिए ना कि भाई हमें कुछ समझ में आया भी है नहीं आया, एटलीस्ट जितना रिक्वायर्ड है वहाँ तक पहुँचे हैं या फिर नहीं पहुँचे हैं। तो आपको करना क्या है, वट वी नीड टू डू दैट, सबसे पहले आप रजिस्टर कर लीजिए, ठीक है, आपको एक स्पेसिफिक गूगल शीट मिलेगा उसमें आप रजिस्टर कर लीजिए, देन एज ऑल ऑफ अस अंडरस्टैंड हर किसी के पास लिमिटेड स्लॉट्स हैं, तो आपको एक स्पेसिफिक कॉल आएगा एंड दैट इज समथिंग विच वी आर कॉलिंग अ स्क्रीनिंग प्रोसेस, बिकॉज अगर हमें आपको ये सारी सर्विसेज प्रोवाइड करनी है द नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स विच वी कैन हेल्प दे आर ऑलवेज लिमिटेड इन नेचर, सो अकेडमिक काउंसलर इज गोइंग टू कॉल यू, दे गोइंग टू हेल्प यू और दे गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड आपकी रिक्वायरमेंट क्या है, हो सकता है आप कॉलेज के फर्स्ट ईयर में हो, सेकंड ईयर में हो, थर्ड ईयर में हो, और यू मे हैव ऑलरेडी प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर सम टाइम एंड यू आर नॉट गेटिंग द डिजायर्ड रिजल्ट, तो इसलिए हमें स्क्रीनिंग प्रोसेस चाहिए होगा एंड फाइनली on the basis of this you're going to get the benefit of this program.